Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we'll go through how to integrate Google Analytics with your Next.js project using Google Tag Manager. If you're building a modern app and you want to keep track of user behavior, page views, and performance, setting up analytics the right way is essential. Google Analytics offers a flexible and scalable way to integrate analytics scripts without constantly editing your codebase. So by the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding how to integrate Google Analytics fully working with your Next.js project with GTM. So also you'll understand the best practices to keep your setup clean and efficient. So let's get started. By the way, guys, if you haven't watched my previous series about Google Tag Manager with Next.js application, I highly recommend them to watch it, since that video is going to be a prerequisite for this one, where I covered all the core concepts of Google Tag Manager with Next.js application. So enjoy. First things first, I'm going to go over to Google Tag Manager and start over completely new account. So let's create it. For that, I'm going to go over to create account. So for that, you are gonna name your company name, but it's completely unnecessary and you can type any company name that you like to. So I'm going to demo company. Now you can specify the country where it is. It's going to be in Kazakhstan. Now you can set up your container. So let's type your container name. You can name your container name as your website as a suggestion, but it's completely unnecessary for this step. I'm going to call this a demo container. Now this is going to be a website for this case, since we are going to use Next.js. So you can agree with the terms and conditions and hit yes. Now it's suggesting us to insert the script into our Next.js application, but we are gonna skip this step since we are gonna use React GTM. Now let's try to create a new account for Google Analytics. For that, you go over to analyticsgoogle.com. I already have an account for my Google Analytics, but for creating a new one, you go over to settings and create a new account. Now you can type your details right over here. Now let's name our account. So I'm going to call this as a demo account. Now let's go next. Now we have to name the property. You can edit this property later on your settings, but for now I'm going to type as a demo property. Reporting time zone is going to be Kazakhstan. Now our currency is in Kazakhstanian tenge. Now let's go next. Now we have to specify the business details of our application, but don't worry if you don't have one. This is going to be totally analytics for Google Analytics itself. So you can specify anything you want. I'm going to specify other business activity since it's going to be totally for demonstration purposes. And you can specify as a small. Now let's go to next. Now let's choose the business objective, and I'm going to specify other business objectives since it's a demonstration. Let's accept the terms and the conditions and accept. So in order to get started with collecting your data within your application, you have to specify the URL of your application. For our case, it's going to be a web. But keep in mind that you can specify this URL later on within your settings. So I'm going to skip for now. Let's go over to go home. Now we have successfully set it up, our analytics. As I've mentioned before, we have to specify the URL of our application to start streaming our events into our application. So for that, I'm going to go over to stream setups. If you cannot find it within your homepage, you can go over to settings and data streams. So this is where all of your stream setups are configured. We can specify it as a web. So keep in mind that this step is very important for integration of our Google Tag Manager, since after setting up our data stream, we are gonna get the measurement ID that's specified with this stream. So we can use this measurement ID within our Google Tag Manager. So I'm going to hit web. So that's the most crucial and important steps where most of the developers fail when integrating Google Analytics. So you have to configure your application with GTM and publish and deploy into the internet in order to insert your URL of your application. Otherwise, you cannot insert the local host of your application, since Google Tag Manager and Google Analytics are unaware and cannot access into your local machine. So for that, I'm going to use Vercel in order to deploy. But keep in mind that you can use any other tools or platform in order to deploy your Next.js application other than Vercel. I'm going to use my previous project that used for Google explaining Google Tag Manager, and which is basically the default page of Next.js application, and it just contains a new component called page, which utilizes the GTM React GTM module within the initialization, and after mounting within the use effect, it just fires a data layer event called home view, which is basically on the mounting fires this event. So I've already deployed this project into Vercel, and if I can visit this page on mounting, it gives me the Next.js default project and fires data layer event, as simple as that. So I'm going to utilize my URL. Now I'm going to paste the URL of my website, which is basically going to be this one. So I can name my stream name as anything I want. I'm going to call this as demo stream. Let's hit create and continue. So once it's mounted, it suggests you to input this script of Google Tag JS. So you can set it up on your own using GTAG, but we are going to use Google Tag Manager for this purpose. So I'm going to exit this one. So one of the downsides of Google Analytics is that you can, after creating a data stream, you cannot right away interact with data stream and start collecting data from your website. You have to wait up to 2 days in order to start collecting it. But usually it takes approximately 2 to 3 hours so that you can debug your analytics. But I'm going to continue this tutorial by setting up Google Tag Manager until our Google Analytics are initialized after the creation. For that, I'm going to copy the measurement ID, which we'll need later on the Google Tag Manager. I'm going to, within the platform, I'm going to create a new tag for my Google Analytics tag configuration after hit Google Analytics. So for integration, we'll need to create one Google tag and one Google event. So Google tag is a replacement for GTAG replacement, which we've previously seen within the integration of Google Analytics, and one Google Analytics event, which is going to be passed over to the analytics platform later on. So now I'm going to start over Google Analytics event. Now I'm going to paste the measurement ID that I've previously copied. So as it says, no Google tag found in this container, which means that we haven't created an associated Google tag for this event. So I'm going to create a new tag, which is replaced by tag ID, which we've pasted before. So this is going to be triggered whenever our Google Tag Manager is initialized. So let's hit save. Now we've created a tag and it says Google tag found in this container. So this event is going to be triggered whenever a page is viewed, but you can customize these triggers anything you want, whether it's initialization or view or custom event or anything you want. So I'm going to create on the new trigger, and it's going to be happening on the page view. Let's hit save. So you can create a new conditions, whether it's all page views or specific pages or anything you want. So let's hit save. I'm going to call this trigger as a page view. Okay, let's hit save. Let's name it as a default name. We have named our event. So you can name this event name, which is going to be passed over to the Google Analytics. So this name is going to be passed over Analytics, and it's going to be shown within the dashboard as it appears on this input. I'm going to call this GA home view. Let's hit save. Now we successfully configured our Google Tag Manager. Now we can preview this. So in order to debug the Google Tag Manager with using localhost within our local machine, we have to copy the Google Tag ID as previously, and I'm going to copy this value and paste into my Google Tag initialization function, which is going to be passed as an environmental variable. Now I'm going to replace my environmental variable, so instead of working with the old container, it's going to be replaced with the new one. Now if we run our project using our localhost, and let's go over to our localhost. Okay, so since our localhost is working successfully, we can preview our project, and let's type our URL into our localhost, and my port is 3000. So let's connect it and debug. By the way, guys, if you haven't installed the Google Tag Assistant within your extension, I highly recommend to do that, since it's a prerequisite for debugging and use this tool from the Google Tag Manager. So for that, after initialization and the mounting, it says that we have successfully configured the Google Analytics within our platform. So as you can see, Google Tag Manager have fired several tags within this preview, which is going to be initialization of all pages from the Google Tag Manager, and also a Google Analytics event, which is going to be an event name of Google Analytics home view, which we specified within our platform. So now we have to wait until the Google Analytics is initialized the data stream for our debug view, and I'll see you within 2 to 3 hours. Now finally, WebStream started working and finished with initialization. Now we can start debugging our Google Analytics using Google Tag Manager preview. So for that, I'm going to go over to within the settings, debug view. So before making this video, I've already tested this out and I'm already receiving several events. So I'm going to go over to Google Tag Manager. I've already started a local server within my local host, so it's already running, and I'm going to preview mode within the Google Tag Manager to preview my local host. But keep in mind that you can also debug your production mode within the deployment, so you can type your URL here and click connect. For my case, I'm going to test my local host, so let's connect it. So it started my local server and I'm previewing my Google Tag Manager. So it started initialization and Google Analytics event, as well as my tag of the Google Analytics event. So now I should see the events that are coming into Google Analytics within the debug view. If you don't see for some reason why you are not seeing the events from the debug view, please make sure that if you have visited your website from different sources, one might be from the local host, one might be from the the production mode. So if you visited from different sources your website, please make sure that you have selected the correct device. For my case, it's going to be from a Google Tag Manager, one from the production mode, the other one is from localhost. I'm sure that the first one is going to be from the production mode. So I visited one time from my production mode, and with the other one should be from my localhost. So as you can see, I'm receiving the events that are coming from my localhost. This is going to be a Google Analytics home view. So if I refresh one more time my localhost, I should receive the new events. As you can see, I'm receiving the different kind of events, including page view, Google Analytics home view, and so on. So in order to make sure that this one is working within the production mode, please make sure that you have submitted your changes within the Google Tag Manager. Let's hit submit and publish. Let's hit continue. And you should see the events that are coming from your website that are displayed, different kinds of events, and explore them within the events tab of the Google Analytics right over here. So that's the end of the video, guys. If you find this useful for you, don't forget to subscribe and hit like button. In the next upcoming videos, I'll show how to add more events, more custom events, and pass dynamic data into Google Analytics and utilize more functionalities of Google Analytics. And I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.